Okay. So, first of all, its symbol is IR, and its number is 77. And the atomic mass of iridium is 193.217 AMU.
That stands for average mass unit.
Yeah. And I just converted it to pounds because that's more interesting for me. So it's like 7-ish pounds. And it has two different isotopes. And one's 191, which has a mass of 190.96, which is about 6.9 pounds. And then 193 has a mass of 192.56, which is about 7.4. So this is like the heaviest. Fun fact, iridium was discovered, okay, that's wrong, but the way iridium was discovered was the same way they discovered another element called osmium through, yeah, I read about it, it was a test they used, and they used the same test they discovered osmium.
Okay, so it was discovered the same way?
Yeah. Life of the isotope really is considered stable. That's a really good one. Okay. How is it used in biology? It is commonly used as a type in high dose rate of brachytherapy, and brachytherapy treats cancer, and it's mostly treated with prostate cancer. And it's like it's radioactive implants in your throat. Fun facts are like this guy named Peter Curl used brachytherapy in 1991. That's when that was used. Yeah.
So we had X-rays first. And then they were using radioactive whatever for brachytherapy. And then we found out, this is radioactive in 1896 of course, then early pioneers in radioactive. Okay. So they were using it.
Negative effects, it is, it's considered to have a low toxicity, and it's known as an irritant, and it's a fire hazard, too, so you gotta be careful. It's radioactive, but they said it loses its radioactivity quickly, so it's not that radioactive, I guess. Yeah, this is not very effective. In 1984, a serious radiation accident in Toronto occurred where 8 people died from overexposure to radiation and lost early in